All right, shalom again, Rastafari. We're at the Blue Letter Bible, this site right here. We're on this particular site, the Blue Letter Bible. If you don't have all the books and stuff, this is a very good search engine right here for the Bible, Blue Letter Bible right there, right? Okay, so let's go back to the page that we just went to. Wanted to give a little more biblical groundation to Judah and Benjamin, right? When you look up Judah and Benjamin, it occurs in 34 verses in the KJV, Judah and Benjamin. We're speaking of the so-called Afro-American Rastafari, and we're speaking of the Jamaican Rastafari within this context here. So as we go through the scriptures right here, we're going to go to Psalm 68, all right? So let's go to the next result right here, Psalm 68. Right, we're going to search down here till we get to 60. Here, there we go, right there. Okay, see Psalm 68, it says, there is little Benjamin, right, with their ruler, right? And it says the princes, notice what it says, the princes of Judah. Now, let's see if they have this come up where you can see the word. You might not be able to see the significant word, but it probably says Rasis. Let's see what it says right here. Let's see what this is how you kind of use. You can use this program right here. Some of the other software is like that says SAR, like the SAR. You understand? Going back to the ancient SAR. You know what I'm saying? If you look at SAR and you reverse it, it's actually RAS, the two R and the S. But there's also ROSH as well. SAR. This is who we're supposed to be. You know what I'm saying? What to say right here? The SAR. Right, it says of a royal bodyguard. You see that royal bodyguard of Judah, right? The cupbearers of the city, or of a prison, rulers and cattle. Then it says princes, right? It's all about priests, right? Down here it's all about priests, the priests of God, the priests of Christ and his kingly character, right? The book of Daniel speaks of angels interceding, so forth and so on. So that's how you check out some of this right here, right? And if you look at this carefully, you know, if you look at this carefully, it gives you some of the detailed description on what a SAR actually does. You understand? Under the king, an official under the king, a military captain. You see, it's the chief head, all overseer, heads, princes, religious office, elders. You see elders, the representative leaders of people, of a particular group of people. You know what I'm saying? And we know we're 12 tribes. We know we're the once lost but now found Beit Israel. It also means patron angel. And then in the terms of God, ruler of rulers of God, when referred to God, he is ruler of rulers, like king of kings. All right? As Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, is Lord of lords, right? And he's the governor among the kings of the earth, right? We're governed in that new birth of Christ, right, of the black Messiah, of the Moshiach. Not just according that he's black, but according to the Spirit, in spirit and in truth. Now, it says, there's little Benjamin, right? And now Benjamin, as we showed earlier over here, let's move it over here. We look at Benjamin. Benjamin is so-called West Indians, right? West Indians or those in the Caribbean, right? But the ruler of the Caribbean, in that sense, would be Jamaica. Jamaica, Jamaica. You know what I'm saying? There's little Benjamin, says, with their ruler, right? Now, in this context, we see that their ruler, in this particular context, concerning the king's business, right, concerning the king's business, would not be Bob Marley at this present time, but would be, in the Federation activities and the Federation works, would be, of course, His Majesty, but the rulers of the people is this brother right here, Solomon Wolfe, the one that was appointed according to what we have heard, though there's not the paperwork or the documentation, so we accept this as a matter of faith. But we have actual documentation that has been upheld throughout the years, even when we were appointed also in this work. You'll send those with I now. We got to find out immediately that his documentation from such a time in 1960-67 was still upheld. So what we're calling for is a unity right here, but if one don't know who they be, you'll understand, then we allow the devil to play us against each other. Then we're divided and then we're conquered. It goes back and forth where some say, well, because His Majesty was said to have appointed Ross Solomon Wolf, this brother right here, this elder, that Dr. Robinson's official appointment from 1967 from the organization, you understand, when the organization was properly functioning, was of, some would try to allege, of no more significance. That is not true. That is absolutely not true. And many of even the imperial, the monarchy, even recognize that there's newspapers, articles in Amharic, that if you can read it or get someone to translate it for you, you'll basically get to recognize that each government, the Derg, accepted it, although they didn't want to work with the African Americans so much, so they worked with the former ones from the British colonies, like Jamaica. They try to play, you know how they do it, they try to play tribe versus tribe. You understand? We see it in different political circumstances. We, of all, should not fall prey to that. So this is an appeal to our brothers and sisters to really understand what the prophetic word here says in Psalm 68. Now, we quote that concerning princes coming out of what? Egypt and Ethiopia stretching forth our hands to God. Now, let's see what it says here. There's little Benjamin. The Caribbean, by comparison, is small compared to those of us in the mainland with their ruler. They have their ruler. It says the princes of Judah, of Yehuda, the so-called Afro-American Negro, the Negroes, blacks, and coloreds of this mainland, it says, and their council. I think this is significant when we're talking about EWF, Ethiopian World Federation. And then also when we're talking about who was it, you understand, according to the documentation that appointed this man right here. We said we wasn't going to get into this, some of the paperwork right here. But let's see if we can show you. This is some of the documentation right here. You can see this, you can pause this, right? And it has full seals on it. You understand? Even the original, this is a copy right here. You understand? This is not to take away from anyone, but this is just to represent the organization. So when we're talking about this particular organization, all of the 12 tribes have a share in it. But if we don't know who's who, you understand, when his majesty said, I am the king of the so-called the Negroes, or lost sheep, the Israelites, we don't recognize exactly that this is real. The throne of David is real. You understand, and what Shashamani means to I and I, you understand, is also very real. And so we're proposing an Afro-American Sefer, or Afro-American Sefers, in other words, Afro-American settlements. You understand, and each people, each of the 12 tribes, Jamaica has it, so far right now, at least that portion is called the Jamaican Sefer. You understand? And that shouldn't make us feel no way. You understand? And they should feel no way that we call for Afro-American Sefer as well. You understand? And each one of these, you see how blessed with the right people, the righteous people, Ethiopia and Africa will be. Don't you understand the prophecy? Even if you look at this list right here, and now they quote right here Zephaniah chapter 2, verse 1. But if you go to chapter 3, verses 9 to 10, you understand? First, let's get through this right here. So it says, the princes of Judah and their council, the executive council, are we speaking about? It says the princes of what? Zebulun and the princes of Naphtali. Now, for a while, I was looking at this in this part, the two, Benjamin and Judah, that immediately stood out. You understand? It was like, okay, Benjamin and Judah, immediate stand out. And when we really study the scriptures, we can see that there's something very mystical about the character. You understand? Instead of studying the so-called zodiac or the circle of animals, you understand? You need to be man. You need to be a man in the image and after the likeness of God, and then study the 12 tribes. You understand, both from the point of view of nationality, you understand, and where in the diaspora we hail from, but then even understand in the sense of the 12 tribes of Israel organization. You understand, which some say is more according to one's sign or star sign. But remember what the scripture says. It's not astrology when we talk about the 12 tribes in terms of what the so-called sun sign is. We know that Jah is the sun and the shield to those who trust in him. You understand? So don't get it twisted. You understand? But when you study even from that perspective, it's very, very interesting. because Jah said to Abraham that your seed shall be as the what? The stars of the heaven. But see, the devil tried to fool you and take these 12 tribes and make it into a zodiac. So you're living according to the Greco-Romans. You're living in a counterfeit, a false image. And then you accept Kaiser Borgia, the Borg, the Caesar's Christ. You know what I'm saying? Only the lost sheep accept that because those lost sheep said that we have no king but Caesar. You know what I'm saying? They do not recognize Yeshua HaMoshiach as their king. So the 1600, circa 15, or 1492, they get Caesar Borgias. You know what I'm saying? And that's who the grandmamas have up on their wall. You know what I'm saying? So when we understand that right there, it's very interesting. What about the princes of Zebulun? Right, of Zebulun and the princes of Naphtali. So we see the West Indies here, right? And in particular, in connection with the EWF and the land grant, we see the Jamaican and the West Indian Rastafari here. We see a smaller representation, but significant for Judah right here as well. Now, there's different jurisdictions also. You have to recognize that. And the British did not want their free people. They want the black man to recognize his majesty, the same way COINTELPRO did not want the black man in America to also recognize, you know, and recognize the King of Kings, recognize Christ in his kingly character, that man on that throne of David. This is why this is a very important book. If one's haven't gotten it, you might have read some of what's in this book on the internet, but there's also some more in this book, and this is the first in a series of the half of the story that hasn't been told. This is on Dr. Malaku Emmanuel Bayan. And now Malaku, you understand, it means his angel, which is, you know, when you start to get into the prophetic book and recognizing who we are, it becomes more and more significant, right? It becomes so much more significant. Much of prophecy just jumps off of the page. You see the living manifestation, both for good, when we know and we are in our proper position, as well as for not good, when ones don't recognize who they are and they're living in the image of the beast. All right? So, right here, this prophetic scripture is very important. So, under Zebulun and Naphtali, so they're princes. So, it says, there's Benjamin with their ruler, right? With their ruler, which is more in a singular sense, right? And then it says, the princes of Judah and their council. Now, understand that in the term and the history of the federation, right? And Judah being, who is Judah? Brothers and sisters, who is Judah? Judah, right? Judah, in exile, is the so-called Negro, the so-called Afro-American, the so-called African-American, so-called colored, the so-called Negro. You know all those bywords, right? Those bywords that they give us. Now, Benjamin is the West Indian, or so-called West Indian, or the, we could say, with the ruler would be Jamaica. Jamaica, in that way, is the ruler of Benjamin. Now, we all know it. But even if one is a ruler, one should have humbleness and really serve their people. So that's a responsibility upon the Jamaicans. Jamaica, Jamaica, Ja make ya. You understand? But he make ya for a divine purpose. But you have to learn, you understand, what that is. We all got to learn. You understand? Because we didn't even see this beautiful picture that the prophetic word is showing us, as well as a solution, you understand, to what this dysfunction that we're presently going through. You know what I'm saying? This, oh man, I can't even, you know, stutter to say it. I don't sound like Moses in a sense. Stutter to say it. You understand? But this dysfunction that's going on, because we're not recognizing, you know what I'm saying? We're not recognizing. Each know what they have gone through, no doubt. The Jamaican Rastafari went through a hell of a persecution. I've sat down with this elder. I've heard him speak and share certain things. And this elder has a wonderful memory of the Bible, although they say he's not a reader, but he has a good recall. You understand? I never heard him say any foul word or anything untoward concerning this brethren. And consequently, and vis-a-vis, vice versa, I didn't hear that. You understand? But there is a testimony that really needs to be published as well. You understand? There is a testimony. There's half of the story. There's more than half of the story that needs to be told. But what about Zebulun? You understand? So if two of the tribes are accounted for, very important too. Remember how close these two tribes were before, Judah and Benjamin. You understand how close they are. And really in the real picture, whether through the reggae or the hip-hop or the dance, or you can still see there's a closeness there. But the enemy always tried to play brother against brother. That's one of the signs of the Antichrist, brother against brother. Now, what about Zebulun? Right? It says Zebulun. I see Zebulun here as being Guatemala to Panama, to Panama. We have a lot of our brothers, our Afro-Hispanic brothers coming out of them regions too. Citing up Rastafari, citing up the King of Kings and his Christ. And Christ, remember, we cannot enter to the Father or to even that throne of grace unless we be born again. You understand? So this is so very vital. This is the teaching of His Imperial Majesty to we. This is His teaching to I and I. You understand? The teaching of His Imperial Majesty, the teaching of Ketamawi Haile Selassie. He came to bear witness of Yeshua HaMoshiach. You understand? To walk out that way in spirit and in truth. You understand? Because before His time, can you imagine if He did not come to cut those days short? You understand?